Today we will discuss Trifolium repens, commonly known as white clover. So white clover is in the pea family, Fabaceae, and it's in the genus Trifolium. So it has three folium leaves, and if you look at the three leaves, you'll see the three bright green triangles. And that will help take you into this species. So the scientific name for this is Trifolium repens. Repens words derived from the Latin language that means crawling. It is the most cultivated variety of clover. It is widely introduced worldwide as plant material eaten by grazing livestock. There are various varieties of Trifolium repens, often classified as small, intermediate, and large, according to height, which reflects petiole, stalk that is attached to the leaf blade to stem, length. Commonly it is known as white clover in general. Dutch clover refers to smaller varieties, and Ladino clover term used for large varieties. Trifolium repens is a low-growing plant with a flower on the head. This is more above ground, so the stems actually crawl above ground and then they root down at different nodules to produce new flowers. However, it also reproduces by seed, and it is a favorite of honeybees. That's one of the reasons why it's redrawn my eye. And wanting to do a floral Friday on this plant, because in the garden I've been noticing all the honeybees on it and just having that fruit feast, and it is an absolute favorite of the honeybees. Apparently the nectar contains 40% sugar, which is really high sugar content. Where a Coke, for instance, allegedly contains about 11% sugar, which is all very high, but 40% sugar in the nectar of the clover, the white clover, and that partly 27% protein. So what is really great about this plant, as many other plants do if they put up their colors, are what will attract their pollinators. Also, from an effort botanical point of view, red clover has been eaten as a pot herb and it's very nutritious, but you have to be careful because it has compounds in it that produce cyanide in the body, like apple pits and peach pits and things like that. Also in India have been used as a form of huge to help get rid of worms, and science has apparently verified that now. Western science has verified that yes, it does help get rid of the worms. So enjoy your white clover Trifolium repens. White clover has compound leaves, which means each leaf is made up of three leaflets attached to central stalk, which is called a petiole. The leaflets are ovate to elliptical in shape, generally 1 to 2 cm long and 0.5 to 1.5 cm wide. The texture of leaflet has a smooth texture on the upper surface, while the lower surface can be hairy and may be paler. The color of white clover leaves depends on various factors like age, region, and growing conditions. Generally, the white clover leaves are vibrant green. White clover flowers consist of various tiny white florets arranged in a spherical or elongated shape. Flowers are small in size and their diameter is about 0.5 to 1.5 centimeters. They are clustered together densely as round flower heads on slender stems. Flowers predominantly appear white in color, but the petals are often tinged with pink or light purple at the base. White clover flowers produce a sweet fragrance, generally noticeable on a bright, warm, sunny day. Bloom time for clover flowers is generally in early summertime, or it prefer a warm environment to bloom. How to plant white clover? Planting white clover is a very easy process like other plants. Here is the general guide to growing it. Choose a sunny or half-shaded area along with well-drained soil. It can tolerate 4.5 to 8.2 pH level soil. Prepare the soil by removing rocks and debris, weeds. Loosen the soil up to 4 to 6 inches deep with the help of any digging tool or tiller. Add organic matter such as compost or vermicompost. We can show the seed of white clover directly into the prepared surface. Scatter the seed thoroughly. Cover the seeds with a thin layer of soil. Water the seed gently to maintain the moisture content. But don't overwater the seeds. Germination takes place between 7 to 14 days. Once the white clover seedling is established, reduce watering frequency. White clover plants generally don't require fertilizer because it is a nitrogen-fixing legume, but if the soil doesn't have as many nutrients as required, you can apply balanced fertilizer. Regularly mowing white clover plants up to 3 to 4 inches promotes dense growth. Benefits of white clover. There are various benefits of white clover plant as mentioned below. White clover is called nitrogen fixer plant as it has nitrogen fixing bacteria in its root nodules. Plant helps in improving soil structure, aeration, and water infiltration. White clover helps to reduce soil erosion. White clovers are highly nutrient plants for grazing livestock. they provide protein-rich forage for livestock. White clover flowers are highly nectar-level, which attracts the bees, and that further improves the pollination if we grow it in our orchard. White clover grows densely, which forms a dense mat, and it reduces the growth of weeds. We can grow white clover on the lawn. It maintains a green appearance when the traditional grass may go on dormancy. White clover helps to increase microbial activity in the soil if incorporated into the soil and decomposed into green manure. White clover health benefits. Now we will discuss white clover's medicinal uses. It has various medical uses, especially traditional herbal medicine. White clover has antioxidant properties due to the presence of flavonoids and phenolic compounds. Due to its anti-inflammatory properties, it is beneficial to manage inflammatory conditions such as arthritis, asthma, and inflammatory bowel diseases. In traditional herbal medicine, it has been used for the purification of the blood by removing toxins and impurities. White clover has been used for the improvement of respiratory health such as coughs, colds, and bronchitis. It has been used for skin care treatments such as eczema, psoriasis, and acne. It is believed to have a soothing effect when applied topically. White clover is believed to have diuretic properties to remove the excess fluid and waste product from the body. White clover has mild laxative properties which will help in digestion, especially reduce bloating and indigestion. How to kill white clover or how to get rid of white clover on the lawn. White clover killer or removing white clover from your traditional lawn can be a hectic task. You can do hand pulling for the removal of white clover. Regular mowing can also help to reduce its growth. You can choose a herbicide that targets broadleaf weeds like white clover. You can use herbicides such as 2,4-D, dicamba, MCPA, 2-methyl-4-chlorophenoxyacetic acid, triclopyr, clopyralid, and glyphosate. We can use corn gluten meal, which is a natural herbicide, to control its growth. Overseeding your lawn can prevent the entry of white clover into your lawn. A thick layer of organic mulch like wood chips or sawdust can help to prevent the growth of white clover.